the biggest ways I've been transformed by this leadership program is really through the networking opportunities and really being able to learn from and collaborate with scholars from a lot of different discipline areas. So even within my own cohort, I can just recall several examples of being able to talk with and have leadership conversations with people with backgrounds from sociology to public health to public planning. And all of these have really transformed the way I look at health and the different things that impact the health of people in the United States. And I think this has been really, really transformative for me because, for one, I never feel like I'm alone. I have a network of people that are passionate about leadership and can help me solve different problems as I run into them in my career, in my personal life. And also just really this experience just taught me to value the diversity in thought and perspectives and really knowing that, you know, it's really no one right answer. There's a lot of gray area in how we approach problems related to health equity and disparities. One of the biggest ways my understanding of leadership has changed is that for me, I feel like one of the cornerstones of being a really great leader is being vulnerable with the people that you work with and being able to be open when you're encountering challenges. I think that prior to this program and prior to my experiences, we have this idea of a leader as somebody that has all the answers, somebody that, you know, is kind of like the captain of the ship and you know, the person that never seems to be fazed. And I think my experiences in this program from the different faculty mentors and the conversations that we've had is that, you know, leaders are a big part of being a leader is, you know, recognizing and leaning into your own humanity and learning that being vulnerable isn't, you know, a sign of weakness or a sign of not being capable of leading, but it really does help you connect with the teams that you're leading. And it invites not only openness and safety with the people that you're working with, but it opens up this space for collaborative problem solving that I think is really imperative when it comes to approaching problems related to health equity. I think my biggest piece of advice is to really enjoy the moment, enjoy the process, remember to slow down a little bit and really connect with the people in your cohort, the different mentors and the different just people you encounter, not only in this leadership program, but the other leadership programs. It can be so easy to kind of have a tunnel vision and only focus on the different things related to your dissertation or research or whatever you're working on professionally. But the biggest transformative pieces for me have been the lifelong relationships that I've created. And those relationships really have changed my life for the better. I can't imagine what my doctoral career would look like if I hadn't met the people that I met through the HPRS program. And so, I would just say really enjoy the people and the moments you get to share with those people because, those moments don't last forever. And if this pandemic has taught us anything, is the value of being able to be connected with others. So, yeah, really enjoy that. Vision for a culture of health in my community is really a sense of freedom in everyday life. And, you know, people feeling in my community that they have the option to seek healthcare and they know how to seek healthcare, especially for me. I'm really passionate about mental health care and equity in mental health care. And so people feeling as if they have access to different resources and support when it comes to mental health, I think that really does build a culture of health and a sense of freedom and interconnectedness between not only people in a community, but also people in academia, people in healthcare. And really, for me, a vision of culture of health is seeing all of these systems work together to achieve equity. And it's not people working in silos or systems kind of working separately, really building a community where everybody's invested in community improvement.